Welcome back to this session of AutoCAD. In this session, you're going to learn how to set up the layouts and take printouts. And more important, you're about to learn scaling. That is, set up the layout and assign the scale for your drawing. I'll be assigning multiple scales by taking up different parts of the drawing, which is very much essential when you are creating particularly structural drawings. In structural drawings, you need to be very careful. There are instances where you need to show in detail the different parts of the structure. So scaling becomes very important. Watch the video till the end and you will find that AutoCAD offers such useful features which are going to help you to assign the scales and fix the sheet size according to your requirement. You should be knowing that printing is done on different sheet sizes, starting from A0, A1, A2, A3, 4, anything, whatever the printer offers, and the situation demands, you need to take that size of printout. So in this session, you are going to learn how to set up the sheet size and how to assign the scales for different parts of the drawing. Before continuing, I should tell you that when you are doing something, it may be a drawing or anything else, you need to be technically aware of all the things you are going to come across in completing that job. This exercise is going to make you perfect in scaling, but for that, as I have already told you, you need to watch the video till the end, and I'm sure that the next time you take up this kind of job, you will do it perfectly and professionally. So let's start. Let's learn the skill to assign scale to a drawing and set up the sheet size, and more so, very important, you are learning how to assign different scales by taking up different parts of the drawing in the same sheet. Okay, let's start. Okay, here I have this drawing which is complete and ready for printing. You have this ground floor plan, first floor plan, and you have this front elevation and section with all these foundation details. What I'm going to do now is also have some specifications here. Now what I'm going to do is go to the layout. You can see layout 1, layout 2. Let us see what is there here. So layout 1, you go here to layout 1. Already there is something which I've done. Let us go to layout 2. Here too, you have something else. So nothing to worry, I'm going to create one more layout here. Just right click and new layout. So you get a new layout here. Okay, so you can create any many number of layouts you want. So layout 1, layout 2, layout 3, layout 4, you can go on creating like this. So layout 3, you have something here. This is a window, default window. We don't need this default window here. I'm just going to delete it because I'm going to create my own sheet size and I'm going to prepare the drawing ready for printing according to my requirement. So the first thing what I'm going to do is prepare the sheet size. So you can do it by two ways. First is go to this button here, start button, go to print and go to page setup. Okay, this is one way. The other way is go to this layout here, layout 3, right click, go to page setup manager. You get the same thing here. There are so many things else here, setup 1, setup 2, setup 3. Okay, I'm going to create my own setup. So new. This telling setup 4, I'm happy with that name. If you want, you can change the name. Setup 4 is okay for me. Okay. You are redirected to this dialog box here, which is very important. You need to do a lot of settings here. Starting from printer, if your computer is connected to some printer, you can just select the printer and go for direct printout. But what usually is done is, what I usually do is convert this drawing into PDF. So DWG to PDF. Okay, this done. Go below, paper size. Select whatever paper size you want. I'm going to select A3. ISO A3 420 by 297. This is the A3 size landscape. You can see the shape here, 420 by 297. Plot area layout is okay for me. Then go to the top right corner, plot style. If you want a color printout, go for ACAD. I don't need a color printout. If you want a grayscale, grayscale is usually when you require the color printout in grayscale. Different colors are represented in different shades of gray. So I don't do that normally, but I always do one thing, that is go for monochrome. Monochrome gives you the perfect black and white printout, which is usually preferred by all the engineers. Travel bottom, leave it as it is. If you are printing on transparency, you can check this box here. Landscape is okay. Then go for custom here, plot scale. Go for 1:1 and click. Okay. You have this setup 3 here, setup 4, set current, close. Okay, now what to do? Now you need to draw a rectangle. The command is rectangle. REC, draw a rectangle exactly. This rectangle I am drawing because I need to create a beautiful border for this sheet. You should be knowing that borders are very important for drawing sheets. It not only increases the value of your drawing sheet, but creates a brand for your drawing. First, check out if this is A3 sheet size. Just go for distance command DI. Okay, both the ends 419.43, it's almost 420. Okay, check the height again DI. So 296 point something, it's 297 almost. So we are sure that this is a A3 size. So now go ahead with the creating the border offset. So something like 3. Okay. Now explode the inner rectangle by explode command. Okay, explode it. So now we can reserve a portion of our drawing sheet so as to enter some details like the company name, some specifications, etc. etc. So go for offset. Offset something like 80. Yeah. So now you should be getting some idea as to what I am doing now. Offset, say 30. I'll just okay. Yeah, trim this. Okay. Offset again, the same thing, 30. Same thing from the top, offset, trim. So this portion is for all your texting and all your company logo, Whatever you want to put, you can put it here. You must have seen drawings like this. This space is reserved to insert our drawings, one or multiple drawings with different scales. It should be looking something like this after finishing. Like if you see here, I reserved some space here. This is all the description of the drawing, specification, and your company name, company logo, north side, all these things, whatever you want, you can go ahead and put it here. Now this space will start inserting the drawings. Okay, now the most important thing, let us start inserting the drawings and assign them the appropriate scales. First, let me insert the main drawing, that is the plan of the ground floor and first floor. For that, I'll use the command mview. Mview, press enter. Just draw, I'm using the half portion of this layout to put this drawing. Let me see how to finish this off neatly. Okay, now I need to select this first, go to this properties, and by the way, this properties dialog box can be initiated by typing properties. So you have this properties dialog box here. Go to the bottom, custom scale, you have standard scale. Just click this. I'm going to assign scale 8:1. Okay, so 8:1 seems to be okay. There are different scales available here. Whichever scale suits this sheet of paper, you need to be selecting that one. So here I'm selecting 4:1, it's too small. 8:1 seems to be okay. I'm just clicking on that. Okay, done. But the drawing seems to be going outside the window. So what I'll do is type MS, enter. MS is model space. It allows you to edit. So now here, don't use zoom in and zoom out. That is barred. We can use only pan. That is, you can type the pan command, or you can hold on to the scroll button here and drag it. So you bring it inside, make sure that the whole drawing is fit into the window. So you can see that the portion of the drawing has gone out. So just type PS, come out of the window, just select this and drag it so that the whole window is, the whole drawing is visible. Okay, now seems to be okay. Double click outside, or of course you can type PS. PS is nothing but paper space. Okay, the top portion seems to be okay, and the scale is 8:1. Just type the scale here, DT. Okay, click here. So scale 8:1. Okay, the scale seems to be too small, nothing to worry. I can just increase the scale by typing the scale command. So say 4 times. Okay. So scale 8:1. So what is this 8:1? So 8 units is represented by 1 unit. So here you can see it is 2.8 meter. That is the actual size when you take it 1:1. But now when it is being printed in A3 size, normally the size has been reduced and we have assigned 8:1 scale. Let us measure this by using DI command. Object should be switched off, object snap. Just measure this distance here. We can see it's 22.35. That is the eighth part of 2.8 meter. So if you, after the printout is done, you take this sheet and measure it with a normal scale, you will find that the distance, that distance is 22.35. 2.8 meter has been reduced to 22.35 mm. So that is what is actually we are looking for. We are reducing the scale so as to fit it into that particular paper, and the scale has to be promptly displayed in that particular window, which is very much required for an engineering drawing. After finishing the top portion, let us see what we can do with the bottom portion of the sheet here. I'm going to insert the front elevation. So again, for that, M view. Okay, I think this space is sufficient for the front elevation. Again, MS. You select the portion, the front elevation here, go to zoom command, object, select this and press enter. You see the front elevation is very much visible now, but the scale has not yet been set. So what you should do is select this, go to the scale here, standard scale, you can see here the properties general box. So what can we give you? So appropriate scale, 8:1, 10:1 also seems to be okay. Yeah, let us select this 10:1. So that done. Just copy this here, copy. You can put this appropriately here. Front elevation done. Now go for the section. What you can do is you can just copy this. When you copy something here, you are copying the scale too. But here in this case, we are inserting the section, and let us see what scale we can assign here. Okay, nothing to worry, just type MS or double click inside. So search for the section here, just go for zoom command, object, select this and press enter. You have the section, but what is the scale? We don't know the scale, we are going to fix the scale here. So just select this, go for the scale, standard scale, whatever it is. Okay, which scale is suitable? 10:1 is okay. 10:1 is okay. 100:1 is too big. 10:1 is seems to be okay. Or shall we change the scale a bit? Something like 12:1 or 13:1, but that is not to be seen here. So we have 10:1 and directly state we have 100:1. So what I'll do is I'll go for custom. So when you go for custom, you need to enter the scale. I'll enter here, say the 12. Okay, 12 is okay. So this is 12:1. Just click outside. So MS, let's use pan. Okay, click outside. We can slightly drag it to your right side so as to show the complete view of the scale. So this is 12:1. You need to enter the scale, appropriate scale. Just copy this, We can place it in some appropriate place here. So this right click, edit. It is to 1. No, this is 2 is to 1. Okay, there. We have some more space left here. What is the scale here? Did we forget? The scale is 10 is to 1. So similarly, you have to change here. DD edit. Okay, now let us insert the foundation portion, which forms the structural part of the building, the foundation. Let us show it in a different scale so that all the details are visible clearly. Now what to do? Go for MView again. Just type MView and draw a window here. As usual, everything is visible in this window, but we need to focus only on the sectional view, particularly the foundation. So what I'm going to do is double click inside and bring the foundation into focus. So we need to have the perfect scale for this. So what I'll do, click outside. Select this, go to custom, standard scale, whatever standard scale is available, is it suitable for us? Let us check out, 8 is to 1, 10 is to 1, and directly we have 100 is to 1, so there is nothing between 10 is to 1 and 100 is to 1. So now we need to go for custom. So what is this custom, where is it available? It's available below here. Just type something like 12 or 13. 12 is too small, say 13. 13, okay, 15, 18, okay, 20. 20 seems to be okay. So just double click inside. Okay, now this is okay for us. So what is the scale we have selected for this? It is 20 is to 1. Let's copy this. DD edit. Okay, by this way we have completed all the scaling business. Let us see what we can do with this border portion here, how to enter the text here so that it forms a template for other drawings. Okay, then we have come to the concluding part of our this session. In this session we have learned how to insert, how to project the drawing in its different components in different windows with different scales. We also put a border here. This border is always useful. You can always put some information, which is usually done. You can just keep it ready. Usually what I do, I keep all the data ready, and whenever the layout is complete, this is the last thing what I do. One very important thing what I want to tell you is, during the process of creating this layout, there is always a chance that you may zoom in or zoom out any one of the windows here and by doing so you may lose the scaling of that particular window. So what you have to do is you need to lock these windows after finishing the layouting work, or in fact you can lock this window at any time during the process of creating this layout, just to safeguard your scales of that particular window. The process is very simple. Just type properties, select the window, come down here, you can see display locked in the properties box in the miscellaneous section. You can see the display locked presently is no. You can make it yes. So now it's safe. Press escape. Again select this one. Go to display locked. Yes. Similarly, you can do to all of these windows. Yes. Press escape every time and select this one. And again, yes. So now what you can see is here, no command works here when the windows are locked. You type zoom, nothing happens. The layout is zoom, but that is not a problem. The window should not zoom in and zoom out. Once the zoom in, zoom out happens, the scale is lost and the whole purpose is also lost. So just remember, whenever your job is satisfactorily completed, you need to immediately lock it so as to protect it from further damage. Okay, then I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I have enjoyed presenting it to you. Thank you for watching. Go ahead, subscribe, like and share the videos with your friends. Any suggestions are always welcome. Any comments are also welcome. And yes, in the next video, I'm going to teach you how to create a nice border and save it as a template to be used in your other drawings. You can always have a look at my other videos, which I am sure will be of great benefit to you. You can find the link to all my videos in the description box. See you until my next video. Bye bye. Take care.